And welcome to the family entertainment edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? I'm sure you're keen to get into that hot seat, so let's get started. Okay, let's take a quick check on the rules. Up to four of you can play the game, and each of you will need to choose adult or junior questions. Then, for the first time ever, you'll be able to choose the type of questions you'd like to answer. There are three categories: general knowledge, entertainment, and sport. Simply choose one and stick with it. All you need to do then is answer the 15 questions that stand between you and a virtual £1 million. As always, you can walk away at any time, and there are the usual three lifelines available to you. Ask the audience, 50-50, and phone a friend. If you make it all the way to a million, you could be jetting off on a luxurious family holiday by entering our competition. So grab your remote control and let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Select the difficulty and category of questions you'd like to play. Great, you're having a go at the entertainment questions. 15 of them stand between you and a virtual £1 million. The first five of those questions can bank you a guaranteed £1,000. Take a look at question number one. Well done, you've got the right answer. A nice easy question for £200. Well done, you just won £200. Now, you've not used any lifelines, so they are still all available if you need them on this £300 question. Well done, you've won £300. Question number four is for £500. You wouldn't want to give me a wrong answer at this stage, would you? And it's a good job you didn't. You've got the right answer. You can guarantee yourself £1,000 if you can answer this question. You had £500. You now have £1,000. It's the right answer. That's what I like to see, five correct answers and £1,000 safely in the bank. This is where things hot up a little bit though, as we try and turn that £1,000 into at least £32,000. Here comes question number six. Now remember, you still have all three lifelines remaining. Okay, you want to ask the audience for a bit of help. Audience, I hope you know the answer to this one. Serious business. Grab your keypads and all vote now. Well, I'd be happy with that result, I think, but are you happy now that D is the correct answer? Is that your final answer? You had £1,000. You just won £2,000. It's the correct answer. Well played. Okay, a chance to double that £2,000 to £4,000 now with question number 7. The very best of luck. Here it comes. You need a bit of help from one of your friends then. No problem. Could be a good move. Pick somebody to help you out.
Hello. Yes, I know the answer to this question. It's A. Make sure you go for A, as I'm pretty sure it's a good answer.
I'd go for A on the back of that if I were. Very well done, that's the right answer. You've just won £4,000. Okay, let's have a look at the situation. You have given me 7 correct answers, and you are now just 7 more correct answers away from me asking you a question for a virtual £1 million. You have only one lifeline left to help you, but it's not impossible, and it'd be really nice if you could at least get to the next big milestone. First things first, let's get you up to £8,000. Lots of luck. Are you sure you want to play this question? Very well done, that's the right answer and it's worth £8,000. Okay, things are getting a little bit more serious now. £16,000 is a lot of money and that's how much you can win by giving me the right answer to question number 9. The drop, if you get this wrong though, has gone up to £7,000. So think carefully before you give me an answer. You had £8,000. You just doubled it to £16,000. Well done. Right, this is a very serious moment. You have £16,000. If you do get the next question right, you'll definitely be leaving with no less than £32,000. Give me a wrong answer, though, and you have to take a drop of £15,000. Not good. I really do wish you the very best of luck. Here comes question number 10. Okay, let's see if going 50-50 will help. The computer is going to take away 2 wrong answers and leave you with just the 2 to choose. Has the 50-50 helped you win £32,000? It certainly has. Well played. You can breathe a sigh of relief now. You will not be leaving with anything less than £32,000. And you might as well play the next question as you now have nothing to lose. Get this right and I'll be giving you £64,000. Have a look, here it comes. You have just won £64,000. Amazing, brilliant. Right, the prize increases really kick in now. The next question is worth £125,000. And believe it or not, you are only 4 correct answers away from winning £1 million. You will lose £32,000 if you give me a wrong answer and you've used up all 3 of your lifelines. Well, there's no going back from this point. You've given me your final answer. I'm ripping up your virtual check for £64,000 and replacing it with one for £125,000. It's the right answer. You could be about to lose £93,000 if you give me the wrong answer to this question. If you give me a correct answer, you'll win £250,000. Now, I would much rather that happened. The very best of luck to you. Let's have a look at question number 13 of a possible 15. You're playing for very big money here. So, is that your final answer? Right, this is serious business. You've just decided to play on a question for £250,000. I can tell you, it's the right answer. You are a quarter of a millionaire. Wow, this is a superb performance. I've just written you out a virtual check for £250,000. Now, hopefully, you can go further. I'm about to ask you a question worth £500,000. £500,000. Remember, you have used up all your lifelines, so it would be a serious risk to just guess at this stage, as you would lose £218,000. Have a look at the question. It's number 14 of a possible 15. You've just risked £218,000. You had a quarter of a million. You now have £500,000. Amazing. You are one of our biggest ever winners. Right, here we go then. This is your one and perhaps only ever chance to win £1,000,000. You have no lifelines left, so you are either going to have to make a complete guess or, of course, you may well just know the answer. I should remind you of the massive amount of money you could lose, but think of what you could win. The best of luck. Everybody here is rooting for you. In which city was Shane Ward, winner of the 2005 series of The X Factor, born? Birmingham, Manchester, Liverpool, Bristol. And I have to check that you are really going to play this question. Is this your final answer? Amazingly, you have decided to play the £1,000,000 question. Now, you could have walked away with £500,000, but instead, you are walking away with £1,000,000. You're a winner. Fantastically well done. Not only have you won £1,000,000, you've also got the chance to enter a draw to win a fantastic, all-expenses-paid family holiday. Just text the winning code to the number on your screen. Very well done, and thanks for playing the Family Entertainment Edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?